Hello, and welcome to another uneventful episode of this disgusting podcast that should have been stopped a long time ago. And not much really happened this week. I went to a barbecue open mic Wednesday night, and it sucked. That's right, I lied. I said it was good, but it wasn't that good. There wasn't an audience like there was last time. It was mostly comics. They were coming from another open mic. I tried their burger. It was delicious. The food was good. But the comedy, oof, not so much. And I'm going to say myself, a lot of people. And, you know, I went on first, and the comedians weren't even listening to me, which is like, whatever. They weren't talking, but they were just, like, looking away. There were some douchebag comedians that came for some other open mic. And it just wasn't that good. There was no audience. Like, the people were leaving one by one. Then the time I left an hour later, there was hardly nobody in the restaurant. So, not much happened there. Then last night, I went out and did my city thing. I went to Old City. I drove down, which I don't know why. I've been driving down almost every week. I used to park my car at the train station. I don't know if it's because I'm nervous that even though I have a hoopty, someone's going to smash my windows, or I don't know what it is. But drove down last night, went to Stowe's, had two shots, two beers. And then you guys saw the taco review. Went to Wawa, got a taco review. And for some reason, that got 5 likes on the channel. More likes than anything this week. More likes than the prank call show. More likes than the JoshCast. More likes than anything. So I guess you guys want to see food reviews. And I don't know if I'm going to do more food reviews, but if that's what you want to see, I guess that's what people want to see. But it was weird, because as soon as I put it up, it said 4 likes. And I was like, really? Not sure if that was from other people, or you guys, or whoever. Well, folks, we have 4 clips to get to. They're really short and sweet. And this first clip is a guy trying to record a fight with some bums, and this fat, disgusted BBC lover, white woman, tries to attack him. What are you talking about? A content blocker here. Here it is. Why do we have to go back? God damn it. Oh!
Oh! I will break your shit, dog!
What's up?
I didn't know Rosie O'Donnell was in The Sopranos. I thought I had a gut. Look at that gunt.
Oh! I will break your shit, dog. Keep it up. I'll break
your shit. Nice. It's funny because it involved a woman getting hurt. I don't know what to think of that clip. First, I was like, is that fake? But hey, man, his friend really is ride or die. And his next two clips are from Little Caesars. Ironically, we did a Little Caesars prank call show this week. So this should be fun. How do I play this? Wait, I feel like this is my first time doing this shit. I don't know why I'm dizzy tonight. All right, sounds up. This is a guy who's angry because he waited 15 minutes and he drops his pizza. Not sure if he drops it on purpose or not, but he was pissed or whatever. So he's got his 2 hot and readies. He opens it up. Looks like he dropped it on purpose. Then he opens up the other one. Yeah, he did it on purpose. So he wanted them to clean that up. That's from the Little Caesars surveillance. And they record that. She's got his license plate number. Not sure if any charges are pressed on that. Then this next one, I haven't watched the whole thing yet. Little Caesars, what is the title of it? Oh, God. I'm out of it tonight. No Crazy Bread. Woman arrested 2 weeks after using slur and slap Little Caesars teen for not having her crazy bread. Police say they couldn't arrest her because the incident wasn't seen by police. Well, now it is. So arrest the cunt. Here it is. Let's get to this.
This video showing her slapping a 17-year-old Little Caesars employee in Enid after ordering 2 pizzas and crazy bread.
They didn't have any of the crazy bread.
71-year-old drove up to the window and started calling his client.
I never saw a Little Caesars drive-thru before. That's the problem right there in the first place. This place didn't have a drive-thru, so then what happened? She's going to get a little fat little short arms over the counter.
Racial slurs.
She proceeds to call him the N-word. She don't just call him the N-word. She prefaces with "you effing N,"
which is actually worse than saying just the N-word. somebody calls me an N-word, it's fine. But if they say you fucking N-word, well then, we got a problem. I'm the black Colonel Sanders from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Well, Schuerman asked the teen, quote, did that hurt you?
Oh.
When the 17-year-old said no, she got out of the car and slapped him across the face.
You know, if that didn't hurt you, then I'll slap you and see if that hurts you. This young man did the best that he could do to control himself.
2 weeks later, the 71-year-old charged with a malicious harassment based upon race charge. That charge carries more weight than a standard assault.
What was more painful to him was the fact that it took so long for anything to be addressed in reference to this.
The Garfield County District Attorney not wanting to go on camera, telling News 4 Enid police couldn't arrest Schuerman because officers didn't witness the misdemeanor with their own eyes.
They had the video. The police department had it. Little Caesars had it.
Police having to pass the KFC.
I think that guy should do the KFC commercial without the blackface. He looks like the black colonel, doesn't he?
Is off to the DA so prosecutors could do their own interviews before getting an approved arrest warrant through the court. Documents show when the manager asked Schuerman what happened, she said,
Schuerman,
quote, I harassed him like I always
Damn,
do.
Damn, she admits to it.
She was just joking.
Oh, she was playing around.
These type of cases would not have taken that long.
Oh, stop it. She's into interracial porn. And this last one, I don't know why I put this in there. This happened 12 years ago. This is a little kid that pants into his teacher. Man, I remember when I was in high school, we had this our 10th grade history teacher. A lot of people didn't like him because he was failing people. And these black kids threw chocolate milk at him. And I didn't see it, but my friend told me, my friend in high school. When they had the class, what's it called? Well, you just had to stay in there. Advisory. Someone threw a chocolate milk and hit him in the face and tried to chase him. He looked like Chris Farley, the guy. But this is probably funnier. Here it is. And you could tell that was old because look at the awful cell phone quality. Man. Well, folks, speaking of awful, this podcast is awful. This is your worst comedy podcast in Philly. And it's your favorite podcast that most people will listen to. And after this, we're going to get to the odd news. Alright, I stayed in last night like an old fucking fat man. I didn't feel like going out, and I decided not to because tomorrow night's my open mic, so fuck that shit. Let's get to the odd news. That's it, folks. What do we got here? Stardew Valley players won't stop making increasingly unhinged grandpa death mods, according to PC Gamer. I don't know what that means. That's in the just red. So it's some sort of, it means death in your careers. I don't know what it means. You read it yourself. Couple found a 1950s McDonald's bag with French fries inside a wall during renovations. Don't throw it away just yet. Sold on eBay. Creepy dolls keep washing up on Texas beaches. Was John Kinzel out there? Anybody know comedian John Kinzel? All right. Planet warming emissions from cow burps have been seen from space. There's a man out there married to a hologram. He can't talk to his wife due to a software glitch. Well, according to the old joke, that's a good thing. He can't talk to his wife. Second submerged helicopter found in Lake Apopka crashed same day as the first, officials say. Honeybees join humans as the only animals that can tell the difference between odd and even numbers. Honeybees! How did they get that study done? I don't know. Fictosexual Japanese man no longer able to communicate with his hologram he married. Is that the same story? I think that's the same story, just married, except they were born. Johnny Depp laughs in court as bodyguard is asked if he saw his actor's penis. That's a Howard Stern question. So have you ever saw Johnny Depp's penis, Robin? That's some more awful pressure than Andrew Cumia's. Search underway for a suspected thief who has very large, very hairy feet in Georgia. Juneteenth Soul Food Festival canceled Arkansas after all-white panel of hosts revealed you can't have all-white people judging food. You gotta have different taste buds. You gotta have different palates. That's racist, folks. Millions of bees bound for Alaska are rerouted and die in Atlanta. Oh, that's terrible. Bees make honey. Bees fucking honey, don't they? Canada to prosecute crimes committed to on moon. Canada. Oh, so people are going to the moon. Right. Meet PC, who went on a Nigerian Big Brother against written warning. Alright. U.S. Army replaces cake it stole from an Italian girl in 1945. Why would they steal such a thing from an Italian? Japan firm develops AI system to catch shrine box donation thieves. A pelican briefly delays San Diego flight with airfield standoff. Howard Stern was in San Diego. That old Howard Stern's disabled like a pelican. Kansas City BBQ restaurant asks customers to avoid brisket as beef prices skyrocket. So why would they tell them to avoid that? If someone wants to pay $80 for it, then let them pay $80 for it. Chaos as American family brings exploded shell to Israel airport. Panic at Israel's airport has failed. Okay, I didn't spread that. Accused wild day started with rough sex, ended with an explosion in a car. I don't know what this is about. Let's see. This is in London. Seconds after explosion, heart attack. Two men tumbled out of a burning building of a Honda Civic. Would burn, so they were fucking in the ass. I don't know if that happened or not. Call of Duty cheaters are being stuck blind by anti-cheat software. They're being struck blind, so they have an anti-cheat software that will tell you that you're a dirty cheater. Texas researchers find dozens of creepy... Okay, I read that already. Edit that out. TikTokers avoid felony by playing rock, paper, scissors with police. Oh, so it's a bunch of... Oh, you gotta see this, guys. It's a bunch of broads. They're in bikinis. They're white girls. The cops have hard-ons. And they were caught by jaywalking or speeding or anything like that. Now, this only works if you're white, you're a woman, and you're fairly attractive. Look at this. Imagine a bunch of black girls like, "Hey, Ray, you see that shit? Did that happen? Chipotle giving nurses and doctors free burritos for a year. Why burritos? Why not burrito bowls? Alan Cumming offering $10,000 reward for missing chimpanzee co-star. Police play Disney tunes to prevent video of them on patrol being posted online. Oh, yeah, so that's old. Yeah, so if cops know they're being... live streamed on YouTube. I think it only works for YouTube, but whatever platforms that violate copyrighted, you know, play copyrighted music. It is smart, but if the person's not live, then they can just kind of edit that out. Baby Line Beast skit mocks Twitter employees as sensitive gets flags for Twitter for sensitive content. Wait, I thought Elon Musk bought Twitter and it was going to be PC anymore. What happened? Bride marries another man at wedding venue after groom fails to reach on time. So this woman, this is in India. That makes sense. Because in India, they have arranged marriages and all that such. They all look the same. Sorry. Fan accidentally buys tickets to Red Hot Chili Peppers cover band is pissed. Hey, these guys aren't the real... They sound like them, though. Family says a bully set a 6-year-old boy on fire with a flaming tennis ball. Damn. I thought bullying was kind of more online these days. I guess not. U.S. conservatives investigating reports of lawmaking watching porn in a parliament PA media. This is in UK. Oklahoma panel says candidate cannot be called the patriot. A woman marries a pet cat in a bid to stop landlords separating them. Hey, I knew that chick always liked pussy. Oh, that's a hack. Come on. Tories investigate claims NP watching Rincon, okay. Now I don't even know what I'm reading now. Longtime Georgia restaurant employee honored for grilling 1 million steaks. Who counted that shit? That's a lot. They're like, okay, tonight's number 646. All right, enough. Man killed and eaten samosa without permission in Madhya Pradesh. Man finds decades old McDonald's inside. But okay, I think I've read that already. A black cat named Jinx was briefly the mayor of hell. That's racist. Jack in a Box will experiment with burger flipping robots. Tesla model and allegedly in summer mode crashes into a $2 million jet at an airport. It's okay, with insurance, it's only like $1.5 million. Let's see. Lawmakers strike the word marijuana from all state laws, calling the term racist. You're a pothead. It is. Oh yeah, so this happened. Megan Fox says she drinks the fiancé Machine Gun Kelly's blood for ritual purposes. She's got AIDS! She's got AIDS! Minnesota state candidate gives speech while labor pausing for contractions. Family finds out old store noises are five bears hibernated under a house. That's who that was. It wasn't some man. A Polish man breaks video game world record with 416 seasons of Football Manager. 35.2 million of meth was seized from a big rig hauling strawberry puree. Customs and borders. Man, that's a lot of meth. Okay, and that's it. Folks, thank you for listening to any of this crap. I think the average person only listens for 5 minutes, so maybe we'll make the podcast 5 minutes from now on. You tell me. But who cares and all that jazz. I'll see you folks on the next one. You just listen to, and we're out of here.